So what you actually need in order to do this stuff is what is called a Google Merchant Center. I'm not a techie, codey type person, so you'll have to kind of bear with me with this. Google Merchant Center is basically where you would upload what's called a product feed, and this is a big spreadsheet with all your products in it with unique identifiers of what they are, descriptions, titles, links to where the images are, prices, savings, all of that sort of stuff. And whenever you've done that, you or an agency or whatever you're going to do can then link your AdWords account to Google Merchant Center. What that then allows you to do is promote the product. Google Merchant Center is really, really clever, and it will tell you if your descriptions are too long, if the prices don't match each other, if the categories are incorrect, whatever it's going to be. But it's a real health check about what you're doing, and it allows you to manage your product information, which is really, really clever. So up until about, well, actually 3 weeks ago, we were down at, we had Google up to our office, and we had one of our best clients in, and our client basically said to Google, how does shopping work? You know, because it's all very new. It used to be called product listings, and it was a wee bit different. And the guy from Google, who manages accounts all over the place, sat there and just went, I don't know. 2 weeks later, we get invited down to Google to be explained all of this stuff. Google didn't really know how this worked up until very, very, very recently. They basically had it as a service, but they hadn't refined what was actually going to make it marketable. So what they've now said to us is, we can refine your product listings to promote bestsellers, high ROI, seasonal product, promotions, stuff from within your business plan, kind of giving you an idea where you'll be going in the future, and it helps you with your budget. Say, for argument's sake, somebody goes on looking for, I want to get polo shirts for all my guys sitting in the office. You guys are the perfect ones to do that. You're going to sell a different variety of product. You probably have your Fruit of the Loom ones, and then you'll have lesser quality, higher quality, all of that sort of stuff. So does it make sense for you to pay Google the same amount of money to try to sell all of those products? Or would you rather segment it out based on your return on investment? So say, for example, going back to the workwear stuff, if you sell a set of knee pads, do you do those? I'm basing everything on what my dad used to spend money on. So you sell a set of knee pads compared to a set of Dickies trousers, you probably make a lot more off the Dickies trousers than you do the knee pads, so you're not going to want to give Google the same amount of money. By setting these things up based on your ROI allows you to structure your bidding properly. And you remember I talked earlier on about your return on investment, how much you pay for a product, all that sort of stuff, margins? It allows you to do that. What you can also do is then look at, say, for example, your best sellers. So with Signature Works, what I would do with you with shopping, I would have a campaign with every single one of your products on it, but a minute bid, maybe 1 or 2p. So if people want it, let them buy it, but it's not costing you a great deal of money. And then your stuff that you're saying about being the best sellers, you put that on with a bigger budget and you put a bigger bid against that because you know that's the stuff people want, it's more likely to sell. And then you have maybe your seasonal or promoted products sit at the very top, and you promote those aggressively for a certain period of time. Like maybe, I'm trying to think of something seasonal within workwear. Wet gear, spot on. So that's obviously, well, 11 months of the year, basically, Northern Ireland. So you might want to put a more aggressive bid on that during a certain period of time. If you structure your campaigns properly, it allows you to do all of this. Unfortunately, what most people do is they upload a feed, they put a price against every single product, and then they wonder why it hasn't worked. Do it like this, Google Shopping can genuinely revolutionize your business online. It's brilliant. So what you want to be doing is you want to think about the different products, departments, and all that sort of stuff and separate out your budgets. So for argument's sake, you might have a campaign for boots, one for trousers, one for accessories, that sort of thing. And if you put them all into the same budget, you'll find stuff is searched in high volume, but you might make money from it. So you want to segment your budgets based on your return. And then you can have certain products with higher margin going to a higher bid, lower products with lower margin sitting at a lower bid. And then if you have seasonal products or anything like that, during a certain time of year, you'll pay a lot more for them. And then after that period of time, you reduce your bid because chances are you're not going to be selling them as much, but there still might be people wanting them. We would run that candle company. We would run their Christmas stuff all year because people still do like the smell, but they're less likely to buy it. So we reduce the bid dramatically on those terms.